have eaten chocolate today, sit down. Ooh, look at that. Wow. If you ever went for 3 weeks without a shower, sit down.
Thank you for none of you sitting down.
Sit down if you've ever broken a bone.
Yeah, there you go.
That took him out.
Sit down and have blue eyes. Can't lie about that.
Lost them all.
Whether it be big or small, you're going through something, you're struggling with something right now. I guarantee that, well, I've had kids that's come through youth group that before, and I said, are you struggling? Yes. I go through, and I had one girl one time, and goes, no. And I said, you're not. And she says, no. And I said, nothing. And she goes, no. And I said, your life is perfect. And I was like, so you have nothing wrong in your life. Everything is just where you want it. Everything is going right.
Yeah.
And I was like, well, that's a first.
Yeah.
Y'all see that?
Yeah.
Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
Does it make sense to you? It does? But, you know, when I was looking at this, that's good, your eyes. But when I was looking at this, I was like, how does that make sense to me? How does that work? How can that not have another cut in it here to make that work? And I was thinking about it, and does anybody understand how this is working? Caleb?
Hunter? Is Hunter right?
You do? Okay. If you wanted to know how to do this and you don't know, and you're sitting out there right now, and you'll admit you don't understand how this concept works, if you were to ask somebody in this room, who would you ask? So we got to turn to the right source, okay? Too many times we have a situation and we don't know what to do, and we're looking at it, and we're looking at it, and we're looking at it, and we're studying about it, and then we're going to say, I'm going to go ask someone who doesn't know. Go ask Henry. Do you understand the concept of this? Okay, I'm not going to go ask Henry how to do this if I know Caleb knows. So it's the same thing. God tells us in the scriptures. God tells us. He says, "I've got all your answers. I've got everything you need." Matthew 21:21 says, "Jesus answered and said unto them, Verily I say unto you, if ye have faith and doubt not, ye shall not only do this which is done to the fig tree, but also if you say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, it shall be done." Okay, so basically it says if you have enough faith, you know you've heard that thing, if you have enough faith, you can move mountains. Okay, you've heard that. So if you have enough faith, you can move mountains. And that's literally what God's saying. So just think about how much faith we must have to get through life and doing what we're doing. And a lot of times, you know, we don't have faith in something when something lets us down, obviously. When a car quits on us, had anybody had a car quit on, like, driving down the road? Yeah. And you're just like, now you're stranded, or your tire goes, it's losing air, and you're, oh no, I forgot to put air in it. And
your brakes
now
are on fire as you're driving.
Your what?
Brakes are on fire as you're driving.
Your brakes are on fire as you're driving. So the next time you drive, you think, man, my brakes are probably burning right now. Glad it's raining. So we lose faith. We lose faith in things, but in order for us to find the answer, we're going to go to someone who knows the answer. We're not going to go to the florist if our brakes are on fire and say, what do I do? Not just move it, but if you cast it into the sea. Can you imagine a mountain being cast into the sea? And I know you probably can't imagine because you've probably seen it on Independence Day or something like that, like a movie like that. But, you know, so we can imagine that, yes, but it's to see that in real life would be like, like, this doesn't make any sense. Just kind of like this. If you're sitting out there wondering how this could possibly work out, you're sitting there thinking, how is this possibly working out? And until you see it, and I'll show you here in a second how I did it, until you see it, you're going to be like, it doesn't make any sense. And it's hurting your mind. And it's like, when you don't understand something, it's like, oh man, I can't get it. It's hurting my mind. And it's like, but if we had enough faith to say, okay, wait a minute. I want to know how to do this. I'm not going to sit there and dwell on it, stew on it, and think about it, think about it, think about it. And I say, man, I really need to know. I need to figure it out. I need to figure it out. But wouldn't it just be easier? Wouldn't it be more beneficial for us just to go to God and say, how do you do it? What do I do? And I know it's not always an immediate answer. And I'm always like, boom, here's your answer. And, you know, boom, here's a text. God says, okay, oh, yeah, that's it. I didn't know. But if you sit there and stew about it. How many times have I heard people say, my life is a mess. When I get my life straightened out, I'll go to church. I'll ask God. But everybody in here is going through something, probably, a situation. Something right now in your life. You've been through something. You're going to be going through something. And you're going to say, how can I figure this out for myself? But it says in the scriptures, it said, if we just have faith, we can move mountains. And that's literal. I mean, that's literal. And if you believe in the power of God, God can move the mountains. And yet God is going to move that mountain through your faith. So, okay, here it is.
I know.